The year was 1497. Vasco da Gama started his voyage from Portugal in search of new land. It took him 2 years to sail across the Atlantic Ocean, round the Cape of Good Hope, through the Mozambique Channel, onwards to Northeast and on to India. Today, ships sail across the Mediterranean Sea, through the Suez Canal and on to India in 2 weeks or less. Today's ships have GPS and gyro compass to guide them in all weather condition. Back then, world was a vast, endless ocean, and nobody knew what was on the other side. Yet, they ventured deep, guided by the sun and stars, to find their way across the ocean. So how did those mariners found their way without the help of GPS or gyro compass? Welcome to my channel. This is your host Abhijit. I'm a mariner and a survey trainer. Here in this channel, I give you tips and tricks which can help you in enhancing your offshore career. Today, I'll tell you how you can find your latitude and longitude without the help of any GPS device. Who knows, this might be helpful to you in the event of a war or a big solar flare which can possibly stop the services of GPS. So before I start, please take a moment to click that red subscribe button if you haven't already. Alright then, let's start our journey. In ancient times, people positioned themselves using landmarks. But as the people started venturing out more and more into the world, they needed some sort of reference frame to find their location on the earth. And from ancient times, people have been using sun, moon, and stars to find their position on the earth. Finding latitude using the stars at night is fairly common in the ancient times. Mariners navigating the ocean in the northern hemisphere have always used North Star to find their latitude. Between equator and North Pole, one simply has to find the altitude of the polaris to find their latitude. Mind it, the altitude here is the vertical angle measured from the observer local horizon to the pole star. So if you measure the altitude of the polaris to be 20 degrees, from your position, then your latitude is 20 degrees. In earlier times, people used a device called astrolabe to find altitude of the stars. Sextant is fairly recent tool and widely used even today to find the angles and altitude of stars. As the polaris is not visible in the southern hemisphere and there is no particular star to mark the southern celestial pole, finding latitude is a bit more complicated in southern hemisphere. Finding longitude though is little bit complex. The concept of finding longitude existed with the ancient Hindu astronomers with the help of lunar eclipse. The same thing was described in Surya Siddhanta. However, this method requires a very accurate clock. In 1714, the English Parliament offered a prize of £20,000 to anyone who could determine the longitude at sea to within half a degree. An amateur clockmaker from Yorkshire, John Harrison, solved the problem. It took him nearly 50 years to perfect a clock that could keep accurate time at sea, even at long distance travel. He saw time as the key and realized that if you could determine the local time from the position of the sun and the time at some reference point like Greenwich, you could calculate the time difference of the sun's position between the two places. And from this, you can work out how far apart the places are in terms of longitude. So how does this work? Longitude changes from east to west direction. As we all know, the earth rotates from west to east, so we see the sun moving from east to the west. The earth rotates one full turn or 360 degrees of longitude in one day or 24 hours. And we are calculating roughly here, okay? So mathematically, the Earth turns 1 degree in every 4 minutes, or about 15 degrees of longitude in every 1 hour. And that's the sun position shifting across the sky. To calculate your longitude, you simply need to work out the time difference at the noon when the sun is highest at your location and at a reference location. Let me try explain this on a chart so that you can understand better. Suppose you are in Mumbai and you want to travel west. On the day of your departure, you note down the time accurately when the sun is exactly at its highest point. Say for example, the time was exactly 12:30 p.m. Now you travel west and a day later, take a note of the time when the sun rises to its maximum point at your location. And you see that the time is about 13:30 at your current position. That means the sun took 1 hour extra time to reach the exact spot on the sky in your new location. And that means your position has changed by 15 degrees of longitude. So, if Mumbai longitude was 72 degrees east, then your new position will be 57 degrees east. If the local noon comes earlier from the reference point noon, then your movement is towards east and the longitude will increase in that case. I hope you understood the concept that I am trying to tell here. These are very simple concepts which the mariners were using for hundreds of years. With so much automation in our life, we tend to forget the simple concepts and calculations. I hope we learned something today. If you agree with me, please give me a thumbs up and leave a comment below. We'll meet again with some exciting new topics. Till then,